Let's go. Hi, everybody. I'm Bjorn Edvin. I'm a DevOps enthusiast. I'm part of the Viliatro family. I'm here to help people, teams, and organizations to get better. Today, I'm going to help you to learn more about DevOps Dojo on how to get started with yours. So before we get started, I want to get some baseline on what a dojo is. It's both a physical space and a way of learning and practicing new skills or also some existing skills. Let's put this into perspective of DevOps. So what is a DevOps Dojo? It's an immersive learning experience where you bring full stack product teams into a safe and dynamic environment so that they could learn and apply new ways of working on their real world products and services. All right, so this hands-on learning environment helps them to improve their culture, their practices, and gives them the strong mindset of experimentation. The practices includes agile, engineering, development, operations, et cetera, et cetera. All right, now are you really sure you want to know more about the dojo? All right, if you're sure, I need your help. I'm going to pause a couple of times in my presentation. I'm going to pause after DevOps, and you say dojo. When I say DevOps, you say? All right, okay, let's fasten your seatbelts. Let's talk about Dojo. My topic is going to be about starting your own DevOps. Dojo. Your own DevOps? Dojo. In 8 simple steps. All right, this is a test. Now let's really get into the topic. Step number 1, assess the current state. There could be teams, there could be tools, there could be platforms already in place, there could be pockets of high-performing teams who are starting to explore. Start from there and slowly build on top of it. You don't have to reinvent the wheel from scratch. This takes us to step 2, where based on your assessment, you kind of build your own toolbox, right? Don't solve for the whole world. Don't solve for the whole gamut of the tech stacks. Take baby steps. Learn and improve continuously. Now, the step number 4 would be to staff your own dojo. You would have to hire and train your coaches, but look for 4 important characteristics. They are curious to learn more things. They're adaptable to real-world environments. They're realistic on hands-on things. And they have empathy to the teams that are coming into the dojo. All right, some person has to help, a dojo master who is always there for the teams, and they orchestrate the end-to-end of the dojo coach who's more embedded into the product team, and teach the coaches the new way of working. Step number 4, dojo space, the most coolest part of the dojo, where people get attracted to the space, the dynamic environment of it, demo launches, etc. Don't get too carried away with that. All right, start with what you have. Start with the conference room, that's fine, and build on top of it. When this all is coming together, you should start designing your own dojo now. This is where the coaches are coming together, putting the curriculum together, the learning paths, and playbook for the coaches itself to implement it. Iterate and learn from team 1. Step number 6, the most important step, is to prep and get the teams ready coming into the dojo. Spend quality time with the team, about half a day. Learn about their product, learn about the team composition, come up with their goals and learning goals and try to get into the dojo. Step number 7, just do it. Run the dojo. Again, focus on helping the teams to learn on real work. There are dojos that are across 4 to 6 weeks iterations. Within those, have them practice smaller cycles. Make this for everyone. Don't restrict people, right? Include all the members of the team, including product owners, include all types of product teams, including your leadership, executives, and management. Just don't say that, no dojo for you. All right, last step, step number 8, is to establish a community of continuous learning, right? Treat your early adopters as celebrities and champions and build a community around that so that they can continuously learn. Internal DevOps days, hackathons, meetups are some great opportunities. A tip, there are communities and experts out there. Look out for them. They have contributed a lot of information, blogs, and learning materials. Pioneers like Target, Capital One, Verizon, Delta, and American are there already doing dojos. Learn from them. Now to summarize, how to start your own DevOps dojo in 8 simple steps. You assess the current state. You build your toolbox. You staff. You prep your space. You prep and make the teams ready coming into the dojo. So now, let's put this all into perspective. What's next after the dojo? Dojo gives you a vehicle for change. You start making a change from your culture of your organization, the operating models, your practices, and the technology changes that needs to happen to support the entire transformation. Hopefully, this was a good beginning for you to start your own DevOps. Your own DevOps? All right. Hit me up on Twitter if you have more questions. I'm always happy to chat about Dojo, DevOps, and transformation. Visit us at liatria.com. I've written some blogs to help you get some head start and some more cool things around there. Thank you very much.